What's going on, everybody? I'm Andrew Gries with NAVAC, and today I'd like to take a little bit of time going over NAVAC's NVR1 Valve Core Removal Tool. NAVAC has spent lots of time and resources teaching proper evacuation practices, which of course include the use of a tool such as this. However, some of you that may be newer to the industry or younger in the trade may have never used these for anything other than evacuation and actually don't know how to use this for its original engineered intent purposes, which is of course to remove valve cores. Now, NAVAC's valve core removal tool is both a 5/16 and 1/4 inch tool in one. In other words, it can be used for both standard 1/4 inch systems as well as 5/16, which is mostly found on your ductless systems like mini splits and VRF. I'm going to go ahead and show you proper use in both applications. Let's get to it. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and kill power to the system, remove our dust cap from the service valve, and then we need to remove the 5/16 adapter from the tool since we are using a 1/4 inch service valve. Go ahead and thread that onto the service valve with the ball valve open on the tool. Once we get that where we want it, we're gonna go ahead and feed that plunger through the tool and wiggle it a little bit until you feel it click and seat on the Schrader core itself. Once we're there, I'm gonna back that out. You can see I'm using my right hand to actually pinch the plunger, and that is giving me extra reinforcement to prevent the refrigerant pressure in the system from blowing that rod back in an aggressive way that could actually do some damage. So we're gonna close the ball valve afterward and remove our plunger, which reveals our Schrader core intact and secured on the end there. Does a very good job at that. We're gonna put our new core on, click it in. Has a really good positive grip there. And then we're gonna reverse this process. So we're gonna thread this back onto the tool with the ball valve closed. Of course, at this point, if you were to open that valve, you would be releasing the refrigerant from the system. Once that's on snugly, now you can open the ball valve. But again, I'm gonna keep my hand on the back of the tool, applying a little bit of pressure to counter the effect of that refrigerant. Carefully feed it back up, and we're gonna thread the new core into the service valve. Once we feel good there, snug it down a little bit. You don't need too much. Close the ball valve. Now we're gonna carefully unthread the plunger, which releases a little bit of pressure. There's a little bit of refrigerant, as you see. Now we can take the tool off of the service valve with our new Schrader core installed. There's a little bit of refrigerant pressure still in the tool, so once we open that ball valve, you'll see that release. This is why we wear our PPE, in this case gloves. Let's go ahead and head inside and do this on a mini split. Okay, now here is our outdoor unit, demo unit, and there is a protective cover over the service valves, which actually is gonna require me to remove the cover. Once we get that off, we use a wrench, get our dust cover off. And this process is almost exactly the same, except since we're using the 5/16 adapter at this point, you can see you can't actually turn the whole tool because of clearance. So we're gonna actually have to remove the adapter again and fix that to the service valve by itself initially. And once that is secured to the service valve, now we can attach the rest of the tool. Since the 1/4 inch end here is a swivel design and can be applied without turning the whole tool. Now just make sure you've got your ball valve where you want it though, so you have access to fully closing. And then it's really the same process. We're gonna get the plunger there down into the tool, into the service valve, back out the core. Make sure we have positive control as it goes back, close the ball valve, then you can remove the plunger and Schrader valve. Reverse the process with your new core, thread the plunger onto the tool. While maintaining control of the plunger, open the ball valve slowly. Press the rod back up until it seats. Thread your core into the tool. Positive control back again. Close your ball valve. We want to make sure we're keeping that control. We could damage the tool, we could blow the seals, damage the packing, and really cause a big mess. Remove the tool and then your adapter. Put it all back together. Get your dust covers back on. Secure the equipment. And kudos to a job well done. Thanks for watching.